is a workflow extension? Well, a workflow extension allows you to use other applications from within the Final Cut Pro interface. Imagine being able to read text or a spreadsheet document within a window that's inside Final Cut without having to move backward and forth between the two applications. But it's more than just that. You can access the full functionality of stock footage, media management, review and approve apps, without ever leaving Final Cut Pro. All this without launching another app or opening a web browser. In this video, I'll show you where to find these extensions, how to install them, and how to use them. And at the end of the video, I'll also show you the best free extension that will allow Final Cut Pro's timeline to scroll as it plays, among many other options. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell so that I can make more videos for you. A workflow extension doesn't replace an application, it simply extends the app's functionality, which is highly convenient when you need to switch back and forwards between the app and Final Cut Pro. It amazes me that this super useful feature of Final Cut Pro is almost unknown by users and severely underutilized by developers of third-party apps. In my count, there are only 17 workflow extensions, even though the feature's been available in Final Cut Pro since version 10.4.4, which was released in November 2018, and it's now 2022. So where do you find these Final Cut Pro workflow extensions? You'd expect in the Apple App Store, but searching there only shows two of the available extensions. Reading-is-Fundimental and Font Audition. However, if you know the name of an extension, some of the others are available by searching the App Store. Or you could go to Apple's Final Cut Pro ecosystem page, and the link is in the description below. To assist you, I've put a full list of all the workflow extensions that I know about in the description below. Once you've located the extension, how do you install it? This is the easy part. Most applications that have the extension included will, by default, automatically install the extension within Final Cut Pro so that you don't need to do anything. And the extension stays active as long as the application is in the applications folder. And this is how your Final Cut Pro interface will look without a workflow extension installed. You can see there's no workflow extension button showing to the right of the background task button. And you'll see it there in a minute when I add some extensions. So I'm going to look at how to install one of the free to install extensions. And this one gives you access to Shutterstock's image library. Don't be fooled though, most of the extensions and videos need to be paid for. But it's a real boon if you're already a Shutterstock customer. I'll download it from the App Store. Click the Get button and then Install, but in this case I've already installed it, so it's ready for me to download. Now press Open and the window shows that it's installed. And it's as simple as that. Now within Final Cut Pro, you'll see a new button to the right of the background task button. And when there's only one extension installed, the button will show the icon for that extension. You'll see a generic icon when more than one extension is installed. And you'll see that in a minute. To use Shutterstock, click the button and you can access the Shutterstock window without leaving Final Cut Pro. Let's type computer and select either footage for video, music, or photos for stills. There are lots of different pages in the computer section. Select the video you want to use. Select the download button. This is your first time using Shutterstock. A new library is created in Final Cut and your image is added to the footage event as a preview. You can go ahead and add this to your timeline by dragging it. but you will be advised when you're dragging between libraries, as it's taking it from the Shutterstock library into another library, and that's the one you've just dragged it into. And the Shutterstock library is stored where you saved it when you first used Shutterstock. And you can check where that is by selecting the account, and it shows in the Downloads folder. The Shutterstock window floats above Final Cut window. You could create a custom workspace so it doesn't hide the Final Cut Pro window. I'll do another installation now of an application with an extension included. I'll access the Final Cut Pro ecosystem page on the web. The link's in the description below. Let's select Simon Says. Simon Says is an AI tool that lets you transcribe, subtitle and caption, and translate your audio and video. The link takes you to the App Store from where you can download it. And if you'd known the name, you could have searched the App Store directly. Once you open from the App Store, you can access the extension from Final Cut Pro. Anyway, select Get, select Install, and add your details. Select Open. This time the extension button shows the generic extension icon, and you can access Simon Says from there. By the way, you can have multiple extension windows open at the same time, and they can be managed from the window menu. Of course, you can also use Simon Says as a standalone application. And this would apply to any application that has an extension added to it. Select it from the dock and it opens independently. And you'll see those actual applications in your Applications folder, under the Users menu in your Home folder. If you delete the apps from the Applications folder, the extensions will be removed from Final Cut Pro. And now looking in Final Cut Pro, all the extensions have been removed. Next, I've got a couple of extensions that you'll find interesting. Font Audition. It's a workflow extension for Final Cut Pro that allows the previewing of fonts with custom text. So you can drag and drop the custom text with the chosen font added directly into the Final Cut Pro timeline. It gives you a big picture view of your text displayed with every font you've got available. This is great for client sessions so they can see and choose their text with the different fonts showing. The next extension is Reading-is-Fundimental. It's a document reader as a workflow extension. It lets you read documents without leaving Final Cut Pro. The window floats above Final Cut Pro, so you can view your document and the project timeline at the same time. It can be repositioned, resized, and saved as part of the Final Cut Pro interface. Check out this video. And a call out to developers. If you're a developer whose users exchange data between your application and Final Cut Pro, consider adding a workflow extension to your app. Use the link in the description below, and this will allow you to get started on creating that extension for yourself. Finally, I'd like to tell you about how to get the scrolling timeline in Final Cut Pro with an extension that doesn't even need to be added to the extension button. It's called Command Post. And once Command Post is installed, a menu button will let you access and enable scrolling timeline. For me, the most useful feature, though, is the ability to save my Final Cut Pro index as a CSV file, so I can copy my chapter markers that are in Final Cut Pro and add them easily to the timestamps in the descriptions of my YouTube videos. It's brilliant. Thanks for watching. I hope you got some value from this video. And let me know in the comments below if you've got some areas that you struggle with in Final Cut Pro. I'd be happy to produce a video to help you solve those issues. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell.